Hi guys, and welcome in this presentation. Today, we are going to introduce the basis of a quite recent topic, online knowledge distillation. This is a very powerful tool that will allow you to harvest the power of a huge but slow network to perform all kinds of tasks in real time.
To do so, we'll explain the different components and how they interact with each other so that you can use the same principle on your own task. Let's go! In this video, we present online knowledge distillation through one of our works named ARTHuS, which stands for Adaptive Real-Time Human Segmentation. As an image is worth a thousand words, what do we want?
Human segmentation in videos!
When do we want it?
In real time!
How do we get it?
Through online knowledge distillation!
This is incredibly ambitious. Let's get started.
As you know, deep learning networks try to model the relationship between some inputs and some targets. In most cases, they require huge amounts of data. And in the supervised case, many annotations to train them. This is where the first problem arises. It can be really expensive in time or in cash to get a lot of high-quality annotations, especially for segmentation.
Well, if you are too short on budget or too busy for annotating your data, your best hope is to use massive networks trained on super large datasets by people or companies who can actually afford it. Thanks to their goodwill, many models are now available on GitHub for computer vision enthusiasts like us and guys like you, so that we can all have fun with deep learning as well.
Okay, assume that you've found one of these nice models for the task. In our case, let's consider MaskRCNN. That big boy is excellent, but super heavy on most hardware, and way too slow for real-time segmentation in videos. Besides, it can segment cars, planes, cats, dogs, and hundreds of things that we're not interested in. Guys, think about it. How would you make it lighter and faster for our use case?
Our solution is distillation. Nah, don't worry. Distillation is also the name given to the process of using the output of a network, called teacher, as a surrogate ground truth annotation to train another network, called student. In our case, we design a simple, lightweight, fast student network that will be trained only on the human segmentation maps produced by MaskRCNN. No need for manual annotations, and we get our desired real-time network.
Wait a minute!
Okay, he caught us. And you too, maybe. It's not yet done. Having a lightweight, fast network comes at a price. It has a very limited learning capacity, and thus won't generalize well across videos. So think again, how to overcome that problem?
Ladies and gentlemen, announcing online distillation. We will never have a fixed network. Instead, we will train a network on the fly to make it constantly adapted to the current video conditions.
So you simultaneously train and use the same network?
That's just clever programming, young Padawan. Here is the trick. We have two copies of the student network. One that segments all the frames of the video in real time, and one behind the scenes, secretly trained in a distillation approach thanks to our teacher. The teacher segments video frames at a low frame rate. Those frames and these segmentations compose an online dataset with frames only from the last 5 minutes of video. And the copy of the students trains on this ever-evolving dataset. From time to time, for example after each epoch of training, the weights of these students are transferred to the first one and the process is repeated.
This way, even if the real-time segmenting student is really bad at the beginning, it then becomes better and better and is always kept up to date thanks to the online distillation. This is mesmerizing.
Of course, we can illustrate the whole process in a concrete example. Let's take a video of a soccer match. let's take a student network with random weights to begin with. At first, no player is segmented. Every pixel is classified as background. The teacher network builds up a dataset for training the fast student network. Let's fast forward to the first update of the students' weights. As you can see, the players are detected but coarsely segmented. Besides, advertisements and the public are unfortunately segmented as well. But don't worry, successive weight updates will improve the segmentation. Alright, this is better, the public is now unsegmented. But the players are still coarsely segmented. The student needs a bit more training. Have a look at that! Now the players are finely segmented. This is amazing! And there is almost no false human segmentation left in the stadium! Okay, now let's see what happens if we pre-train the network and compare the offline distillation with the online distillation. At first, the networks are the same and thus produce the same segmentation maps. The student trained online keeps on producing better segmentation during the match. It has less false positives, such as the field lines, not detected as humans anymore.
We can also show that the online distillation outperforms the offline distillation, where the network is trained beforehand on several other soccer matches. Interestingly, the student may even surpass its teacher in some particular cases. Have a look at this frame. This is amazing. Naturally, we can apply this to other videos, like basketball or surveillance cameras.
We could also take another example, where one modality is very slow to compute, but we have a very good method on it, and we want to make predictions at a much faster rate.
Alright folks, let's sum up this online knowledge distillation principle in a general context. Here's our recipe. You have a real-time processing task of a video and a big, powerful network too general and too slow for it. And you should design a fast, lightweight network for your task. Use it to perform your real-time task on the video while training a copy behind the scenes thanks to the output of the big network. Periodically, update the former so that it becomes better and better. Keep your system up and running. You've got your real-time processing tasks served.
That's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. This was just a small introduction to online distillation. If you are interested to get more details in a second video, please tell us in the comments down below. And, as always, feel free to contact us if you have any questions on the paper. And see you next time!